And then there are those things that just cannot wait. And this is one of those things, because the numbers are rapidly increasing, and inside the hospital, they have the most COVID-19 tested positive throughout. And without further ado, we're going to go into a prayer. I'm just asking that you join us even in meditation. First, I would like to say, God rest the souls who we have lost. God bless and heal those who are suffering and fighting COVID-19 as we speak. And right now, I'm asking that everybody please close their eyes just for this moment as I speak to you and our Creator to ask for His mercy and His grace upon our women and our men inside of these prisons. Of the Department of Corrections. Touch the heart of our governor. Touch the heart of the parole probation officers. Everybody that is involved, the gatekeepers, so that we can reunite with our loved ones and they can fight this battle as we are today. In your name, God bless. Thank you for putting me in a position where I can allow their voices to be heard and understood. I know the conditions and the environment on the inside because I get out and I work out of prison. But I did not do that for those that I left behind. Amen. And I am asking you, Father, to step in and give our leaders the wisdom and the courage to do what needs to be done, and we know what that is. Amen.
Amen.
Messages that you're sending to us at Vote. We hear you. We care about you. We love you.
And I'm here this morning to let my sisters know that we are praying for you. That God is a powerful, awesome God. And God answers prayer every day. These ladies that are in here, it could have been me. It could have been me. But I want you to touch your hand. Still a human being, and you still deserve to be protected from everything that's going on right now. So, I know my family and friends, I want my sisters to know, and I even though God is in control today and always. Be blessed. Once again, I am Lakeeta Smith. And the reason why I am here today, I am here for those women. I am here for my cousin who is sentenced to life, Tiffany Wood. My personal reason why I'm here, but my advocacy and the vote organization is another reason why I stand firm with these women. And I just have a message of love and hope. I am praying for you guys. And from the bottom of my heart, I am sending you all of the strength, courage, and love that you need to fight this. And I wish you all the mental wellness that you can have under these circumstances. And I'm here. If you ever need to talk, I am here. You can find me on Facebook, Lakeeta Marie Smith. If there's anything that you want to talk about, if you have loved ones who want to reach out to me, you can do that as well. I'm very reachable. I love you.
You know, in Matthew 25, starting at verse 4, it states, when I was hungry, you fed me. When I was thirsty, you gave me drink. When I was a stranger, you took me in. When I was naked, you clothed me. When I was sick, you visited me.
Yes.
And when I was in prison,
yes,
you came to me.
Yes.
These are all needs that require immediate action. We can't just sit around and just allow the numbers to keep escalating when things need to be done. And it's going to take our leaders, it's going to take our officials to step up and do what needs to be done. Glory to God for the life after 50. Andrea gave birth and then died in a federal prison on a nonviolent offense. Women, men are dying in prison. And we want to know what is the plan to help them survive during this crisis. Thank you. I am Ivy Mathis, organizing with Vote Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
That's right. That's right.